Good morning and good afternoon. Dear dignitaries on the dais, delegates come from various parts, ladies and gentlemen and media, good morning to everyone. First of all, I want to thank ICT Academy for giving me an opportunity to stand in front of you and talk and share some of the points. Because Sukumar said is the 10th event of ICT Bridge, but really is a bridging between the students and the IT world and everyone. I have full congratulations to Mr. Sukumar and ICT Academy because it's unique in the country. The first time happening in Tamil Nadu, as Tamil Nadu always taking lead in many of these things. This ICT Academy also one of the example for that. The full credit to Sukumar who runs this one very, very successfully for that one. Sukumar, thanks for giving me opportunity. Actually, I'm standing on the boundaries of technology because in front of many of the speakers have spoken many of the points. And today in the afternoon session, we are going to talk many other things, how the technology beyond the boundary is going to reach. So I'm virtually on the boundary. And you'll try to share some of my points to give an opportunity at this one. See, the first boundary break happened thanks to IT, because earlier we missed the industrial revolution, but thanks to our education system, which put India in the right time, right place to take up what you call knowledge economy or internet economy. The first boundary break happened in the early 90s when the Americans wanted to see how they can cut down the cost, how they can improve their business model using the IT. Then they chosen our India as the best place, because many of our people who studied from our colleges gone and they become our ambassadors. Because the time difference between India and the US, all of you know, almost like 12 hours. When American goes to rest, we work the system. So they brought the technology and we started developing this one. Then that is the time government of India felt, yes, we should make use of this opportunity. See how we can support this technology break or barrier break boundaries. So the government of India, thanks to one Mr. Vittal, who was the Department of Electronics Secretary at that time, he has created software technology parks. So even though we call it a CPA park, we don't have a physical boundary. We are a virtual park. We support IT industries across the state, across the country, wherever we are. So being that one, we thought the external technologies should be placed. We created those days internet using the satellite communication. Because satellite communication, we are, our youngsters who are developed the software programs able to reach the US or wherever the clients need. Otherwise, earlier days, I don't name even one of the leading IT companies those days, they make the software in 8-inch floppies and send it to the courier so it reach after 3 or 4 days time. But because of the technology, now we can access with thanks to internet. Today we know we are called smart technology, smart city, various things are happening. Second thing is, because today with technology beyond the boundaries, is because there's no border, because today our youngsters are software industries, what you call the British once upon a time, they said, there is no sunset in their kingdom. Like that today, there is no sunset, rather we follow the sun. Some of the IT industry works for the Australian clients early morning, right from 4 o'clock, follow the sun till the American systems. That means we work 24/7 effectively because of the technology. So like that, we can go and talk many things. Technology, especially the internet, made a lot of things. Today, we moved into value systems. Last two years back, I was went to one of the, because we want to prove, because now software companies just look like operating, coding, writing this one. We want to move to value systems. We government of India very keen how we can create more of innovation, product development into this country. As a part of delegation, I went and saw the Israel Incubation Center, where they created one product, now it is almost coming to the market. Today, the smartphone has become another medical device. Recently, I came across the device which is available for 50,000 rupees in India, which has got an ECG machine, which has got a BP machine, a sensor. Also, you can take your blood sugar. It is well connected to your SIM card to the nearest doctor. Like your internet, you can talk to the doctors. You can make a small network. So anybody who can have this one automatically test it, even something. For example, suppose I feel uncomfortable, immediately I can take my BP, immediately send it to my nearest doctor. The doctor panel of doctors can also consult. They can immediately send needed any ambulance, or they can send the doctor advice if they need medical like that. Technology is no boundary at all. Technology is actually called its only facilitator. In that way, STP now become a facilitator to growth of in this country. Now we become supporting industry more and more of innovation. In this connection, we are starting in all our STP centers, the incubation places. Even in some of the colleges also, we are tying up where we can start incubation. One of the examples happened in Coimbatore, Kumaragiri Engineering College. We started incubation center where some of the companies incubated, moved into the value chains. So other one is now we are having a lot of IC design companies in this country. If you see this, Bangalore, Chennai and Hyderabad become the triangle hub for more of IC designs. So we thought we should create a characteristic lab. So STP is setting up a first cash station lab in Bangalore with the support of the local government. That is, the cash station lab nothing but the companies who make the ICs, they have for testing first product, they have to send it either to Singapore or Taiwan. It takes a lot of time, it needs at least two or three iteration, it takes a lot of time and money. To avoid that, this characterization lab will help to see the testing so that our more and more product can be made, because all of you know that our electronic import going to cross the oil bill. We expect by another 2020 or 23, the electronic import of components will cost more than 400 billion. So we are looking how to reduce that import burden. All of you know, government of India now putting out of fiscal constraint. Like yesterday you would have seen the TV price, I mean import of TV is banned. But electronic component going to be a big burden for our country. So we are creating more and more support of incubation innovation towards the IC creations. Shortly we are also going to come up to some of the VLS incubation on a cloud mode concept, because the tools are very, very expensive. Very short, another maximum 6 months time, we create a VLS incubation across the country on a cloud mode, so that some of the youngsters, wherever they are, they can make use of these facilities, they can make more of IP creations, IP product. I'm also requesting, as Mr. Jain rightly said, reading is more important. Our colleges also should tell our youngsters how they can create more of IP protection, how they can create IP, how they can move into value chains. So today, because of the internet available, because of the smartphones, many of our youngsters sitting in the rooms, sitting in the colleges, they're creating ways. I don't want to name, he is from Chennai. He has created a novel product. We support him last in one of the event. He has now got a good business model. What he did is, using his Apple smartphone, you take your photographs, especially some of the ladies are sitting here, very most useful to them. Take a photograph of you using your Apple phone. Then log on to Lakme or like this, some of the beauty products we are selling. You can select which of the lipstick you want, which of the sunglasses you want, or which of the hairstyle you want to make it. You can select from the album, from catalog, download it. You press the button, it will apply on your face. You can see how it is good. Then you can send an email so the catalog company can send the product to you. Like it's a small product, but a lot of market availability is there. Employment opportunities available. Even yesterday when I was traveling with Mr. Nascom Purushottaman, he was mentioning one of the instances. He started in Calicut, a small company with 20 people. Now he's having 4 branches and 200 people. So we look into this one rather than developing the technologies as needed, but we should motivate the youngsters, creating self-employment. There become a more of innovators, this one. So in that way, what else facility support needed? STP ready to do that one. Very shortly, a lot of more of incubation will create it in our places. With this small speech, for the opportunity given to me, I want to thank. I'm sure our youngsters bring more and more value to the country.